first, fighting out of the blue corner, she is a mixed martial artist, standing at 158 centimeters tall, weighing in at 51.8 kilograms, holding a professional MMA record of 3 wins, 1 loss. From Jikiszod, fighting out of Biala Podlaska, Poland, she is PLM MMA atomweight champion, Lena Korewska! And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, she is a mixed martial artist, standing at 163 centimeters tall, weighing in at 51.9 kilograms, holding a professional MMA record of 3 wins, no losses. From Evolve MMA, United MMA, fighting out of Hawaii, she is two-time Pancration World Champion, Unstoppable Angela Lee! When this battle begins, your referee in charge, Olivier Cost.
Back of the head and spine. As you know, no footstone to the head. Don't grab the fence. Listen, my command all the time, defend yourself at all times. Touch glove if you want. Back your corners.
Oh, it took them a while to decide if they wanted to touch gloves. Lena Korewska, it's worth pointing out, had the only loss on her record came by way of a premature stoppage. I think there was an accidental injury and she lost a technical decision.
Ready?
So let's take that one in our stride. Angela Lee is also 3-1, 3-0 in the one championship cage. Oh, good right hand from Lena.
From the input that I heard from the family, she really wants to showcase a new level of striking. She feels she didn't really get to showcase those skills in her last fight, and she's looking to bang what she's doing right now.
Big right hand, though, from Lena.
And that'll change everything real quick. The game plan's only as good until you get punched in the face.
3 submission wins are impressive. You can understand why she wants to demonstrate some stand-up proficiency, but Lena is a tough cookie. Look at those quads on the Polish girl. She is in great shape. She looked in incredible condition in the weigh-in, and that was a super right hand. Angela Lee took it well.
She's got a big overhand right, and then she lands on top when Angela Lee tries to take her down. Scrambling back up to her feet. Angela's got the back. Picks her. That's a big belly-to-back suplex. Puts Lena on the floor, and Angela's working for something here. She's kind of gotten a headlock. Lena's going to throw her over into the side control.
Tremendously well matched, these two, aren't they? What a battle this is already turning out to be. We're less than 1.5 minutes in.
Angela's back into half guard, and she's trying to work. Lena's just applying so much pressure, just flattening her back down onto the mat.
Now, this is the biggest trouble Angela Lee's been in her short career so far. Not to say she won't come out of it, but it's a great matchup this is.
Lena's got good pressure. You can see those legs of Angela's trying to butterfly hook her and try to get her over. But Lena's worked some really good wrestling skills. She's got an inverted triangle right now.
This could be trouble for the Polish girl. She's taking punches to the head as well.
This is a dangerous position. There's a kimura right there, which is a shoulder lock. But Lena transitions into one of her own. You can see this inverted triangle. She's got the head and arm kind of trapped in that choke position. If she applies, she can submit her from this position. There is a choke here, but Lena's doing the right thing by protecting her side with that arm. And Angela's trying to go after the other arm. This is high-level grappling right here, Steve.
Oh, look at that leg, the torque. She's getting it, twisting it away.
A possible knee lock coming in. Angela's trying some unorthodox submissions here. Trying to add another weapon to her arsenal to complement that twister that we saw back in Singapore.
She's trying all sorts with the leg there. I'm sure Angela knew this was a step up in class, but it's coming into play in practice here.
We've got a possible heel hook here, Steve.
It's all going on.
You can see she's cranking on that heel right there.
Yeah, she is really twisting and turning it, taking a heel to the face with the right leg.
It puts nasty torque on the knee right here. Lena's trying to heel kick out of this. She's got to roll, she's got to move, she's got to try to get her leg out of position so it takes it away from danger.
This is perhaps the most sophisticated women's mixed martial arts fight we've seen so far in one championship.
For surely on the ground, this is transitioning from leg locks to, inverted triangles. This is a plethora of submissions being showcased right here by these two women.
Angela Lee is taking a beating to the face with that heel. Good punch there from Angela.
There's another heel hook shot by Lena. Possibly Achilles lock.
Brutal downward punch from Angela Lee. And the crowd felt that. The crowd is really getting behind this one. It's just back and forwards. Tremendous action.
That was a nice little sweep Lena used to get Angela back on the ground. She transitions into a leg lock of her own.
How are Lena's legs standing this pain? They're being twisted and turned into all sorts of unnatural positions. Watch for the tap.
She's getting torqued on right there. She's got that, Angela's got that heel hook in deep. The dexterity of Lena's legs is pretty amazing. She's got 30 seconds to survive this.
Angela coming back with a heel to the face of her own there. These two girls, tremendous entertainment. We're in the final 15 seconds.
There you go, going right back into that heel hook. They've each kind of got a leg of their own. One's going for an Achilles lock, one's going for a heel hook. They're going back and forth. I think we're gonna run out of time and we're gonna see a second round, Steve.
Well, I'm so delighted about that. That was just enthralling. We're gonna come to Rich Franklin in a moment, but let's just look at some of the tremendous action.
There's
it all started with a big right hand.
Overhand right by Lena Crott and rocked her. There's that belly to belly suplex, but Lena lands on top. Here's that belly to back, kind of a belly to side suplex, picks her up and puts her down onto the mat. Beautiful takedown.
That's got to be competing for the best 5 minutes of women's mixed martial arts action that we've seen in a one championship cage.
There's that attempted inverted triangle, and here's a sweep that puts Angela Lee down, and Lena tries to get back up and initiate that takedown. So let's go to Rich Franklin and see how he has this round scored.
I'll tell you what, this is a close fight up to this point in time. I actually have Angela Lee ahead on the scorecard. She earned a big takedown there. And this fight's really been about ground control. Both of these girls are scoring on the ground. Lena with some of the topside position and a little bit of the ground and pound that she's doing. But I had to edge it out to Angela Lee because she's just working submission after submission. Nothing that I would actually score a near finish for. Uh-huh. I just have her ahead on ground control.
Let's just all agree that we're stoked that a second round is coming up. Tremendous entertainment, and these fans at the Mall of Asia Arena are absolutely loving it. This fight brought to you by Under Armour.
Lena's just bobbing back and forth, looks really comfortable and relaxed on her feet. Angela's pushing forward, and Lena's throwing that big overhand right to try to clip Angela, which she's done successfully twice already.
Oh, good straight punch there from Lena. But she jumped into trouble.
Yeah, Angela slid right into that headlock takedown. She got hip tossed, put down onto the back. So now Angela's kind of working from this side control position. And a little bit of punches of her own. She's trying to trap that arm. She's actually trying to push that arm down in between her legs. It's going to alleviate a lot of defense that Lena's going to be able to do.
Tremendous strength from Lena, and that's part of the problem that Angela's facing. She's got very high-level wrestling here, but Lena's so strong.
Yeah, she popped her head out of that. Now she's taking Angela's back, and this is a different position for, you know, Angela has not encountered this type of adversity in the ground game. You know, so Lena's actually bringing it to her on the ground. Kind of a sacrifice fall there where Angela kind of ends up on top, back into side control. Ooh, big knee.
Close to the back of the head. She's got to be careful with that.
Angela's trying to slide that knee in. Lena's rolling with her, has a death grip on that head, and she's rolling over onto the side.
The state of play changes so rapidly with these two.
Lena gives a thumbs up, says she's okay. Let's see if she can transition out of this. Angela's got a deep hooks inside of it. She slides
round and does that beautifully well. What a contest this is.
Beautifully done. They're just rolling back and forth.
It all just changes so quickly.
Angela's sitting back into side control here. Dropped an elbow into Lena's...
Right on the jawbone, wasn't it? Or the cheekbone, I should say. Don't underestimate the damage that knees like that to the side of the head and sharp elbows can do, even while these two are concentrating very hard on their grappling. Olivier Coste just having a word with Angela Lee to make sure she doesn't connect with the back of the head. Those are illegal blows. If the fighter turns away and gives you the back of the head as you're throwing that knee or that punch, then that's not so much illegal. It's the recipient's fault, as it were, but got to be careful.
Angela Lee's got the back now of Lena. She's trying to flatten her out. This is a bad position for Lena to be in.
I think we've seen that she's got the strength to get out of that kind of position, though. She's a very strong girl.
Yeah, she's got to start moving and scrambling, because right now you can see Angela's just sinking that choke in deep, and she's under the chin.